We wanted the color sensor to find the edge of the line by going from white to black. We can do this by stopping the motor, which is left on the screen, and only having the motor on the right going, like this. To send these commands to the robot, we'll start up LEGO Mindstorms as usual. We will file, left click on file, left click on new project. We've used the move tank command a lot and we can use that again. We want one of these to stop. We can either move that to zero like that, and the other one will change to our usual testing speed of round about 50. And we don't want one rotation. We don't know how many wheel rotations our robot will have to go until the light sensor sees the black. And so we have to change that from on rotations till on. Okay. So we've put the motor on. One motor is zero, the other motor is a moderate speed of 50, so that will turn it round a bit. And we'll remember from our sumo lesson that if we downloaded this, it'll go through the program so quickly, 1/100th of a second or something like that, that our little robot probably won't even move. So we have to go down here, have the orange one going up, and pull a loop in. We'll pull the loop in and we'll move our motor commands inside. And this will mean that the EV3 goes around this loop continuously and keeping the motor going. That 8 on its side is an infinity sign. It goes unlimited. It keeps going around that loop forever. Okay. And that's pretty much exactly what you want, except that we won't know at this stage when it strikes the black line, because we haven't put anything in about the color sensor. To have our robot respond to the change in shade from white to black, we make sure that it's the orange rectangle that's up here. We move across to the switch and we move the switch into our command line. Things are getting a bit squashed up here, so we'll get rid of the document your work window by left clicking up here. We'll change to the pan or hand symbol. We'll left click on that and drag our program down so we can see what's happening. Okay. And then we go back and we'll change to the select or arrow key by left clicking up there, and we're right to go. Now we have to modify this switch. At the moment, as you can see, it's set to the touch sensor. We don't want it set to the touch sensor. We want it set to the color sensor. We want to compare colors and we want the reflected light intensity. So we'll left click on that and you'll see less than or equal to, and we've got a little bouncing thing showing it's a reflected light. Now we usually work with greater than or greater than or equal to. Let's use greater than or equal to 3, and we'll have to work out a value for this. Click on the right hand button twice to get to port view. Once we get to port view, press the center button. You'll find now we have the sensor ports 1, port 2, port 3, and port 4 is where we have the color reflected sensor. Okay, now the value we read from that, you can see for the black, will come up and we get a value of 4%. Now the value for the white area, we put it on white, and the value we get for that in this particular case is 72. Now this number here will be the average of the black and white values. In the video you've just seen, the black value was 4, the white value was 72, add them two together, and you get 76, divide that by 2 and we'll get 38, and 38 is what we'll put in here. However, your values will be different. The light in every room is different, and you won't get 38. You may get a higher or lower value. In my room, if the light value is greater than 38, it's on the white. And when it's on the white, what we want it to do is to do this, to curve round looking for the black. Okay, and so what will happen is that it will come through here, it will see white, the value is probably in the 70s, it will be greater than 38, it will curve, go around, greater than 38, keep curving, and eventually it will find the black and go down here. At the moment we do nothing. Okay, but let's just download that to our EV3 and see what happens. What we want to happen is that the robot would turn in the direction indicated by the arrow. What actually happens is that it goes this way, which is the opposite to what we want. This video is getting rather long, so we'll show you how to correct that in the next video. Thank you.